sunshine.
I have one question about why you decided not to include whether or not the river is meeting its MFLs, where you set the MFLs at the gauges. And I'm assuming you know the answer to that, but I noticed that it's not. I've spent a lot of time in the Middle Suwannee or Upper Suwannee River report, and I see that the MFLs have been proposed, but there is no indication of whether or not they're being met. And like I said, it's not difficult for with all the data analysis you've done to determine if they're being met or not, or if they will be exceeded in the next 20 years. Can you give me some idea of why you all decided to do that?
Sure. I think what it mainly comes down to is that through your review and other public comments that we receive, there's a good chance that numbers may change somewhat. So we didn't want to go ahead and start putting it out there whether the MFLs are being met or not, and probably draw a lot of attention to that when ultimately we may find that we needed to adjust those analyses and that could change the determinations. And I will say, what we intend to do is similar to what was done for the Lower Santa Fe and Chepecni MFL reevaluation recently, where once we have these MFL values set, we'll be able to calculate how much water would be available under that kind of pre-pump or no-pumping condition. And then we'll compare that to what our groundwater models say and the impacts are. So we're expecting to follow the same kind of process there as to how we'll do the status assessment. But since we don't know what the final numbers are going to be yet, that's why we haven't taken that step.
Why was 2015 chosen as the last year in the reference time frame?
Sure. We'll get into that a little bit more, but essentially that's when we had the water use data sets fully available for doing those types of adjustments to the flow data sets we use. So there's a bit of a lag between where we are today versus when those water use data sets get fully prepared to do that analysis. So that's where 2015 came in. We do feel pretty good about that. I mean, we'd like to be using more recent years' data too, but we have about an 80-year period of record for each of the gauges we're looking at here for these MFLs. So I think adding a few more years on the end wouldn't really change anything. Yeah, that was our thought process.